safety bar squat, Bulgarian split squat, long hamstring curl, superset with dumbbell Romanian deadlifts.
These suck. What's up, everybody? Matt Dashu here from Blue Star Nutraceuticals. Welcome to day one, week one of our Load and Explode program. We've got a doozy prepared for you today. This is gonna be a tough, tough workout. You're gonna have a hard time walking out to the car, never mind getting out of it when you get home. So our day one day today is gonna be our max effort lower body day. For max effort, what I mean by that is you're gonna be doing the most amount of reps you can do, the most amount of weight you can do for 12 rep max with our main movement, okay? Enough talk about that, let's get to the exercise. My first exercise of the day today is the safety bar squats. Your variation might be a little bit different, but I've picked that one, so it's gonna help me with my weak point. Big thing to keep in mind here is the tempo today. So on your form in your PDF, you're gonna see the tempo written down as 2-0-X-0, okay? So anytime you read a tempo, the first number is gonna be the eccentric portion. So in this case, I'm gonna be lowering the weight for a count of 2 seconds. The second number will be if there's a pause. In this case, there's no pause. The third number is the concentric action. If you see an X, that means you want to move that bar as fast as humanly possible, and that's because the X stands for explosive. And then the zero at the end would be if there's a pause at the end of the movement. In this case, there isn't one. So 2 seconds down, no pause, explode up for that movement. And since this workout is gonna be a nightmare in terms of volume, you'd be crazy if you didn't want to take a scoop of PPK with it. And let's be honest, every great workout starts with PPK. All right, go time. I pretty much always will do an opening set with just an empty bar. This allows me to groove the pattern and get in for some of those deep hip stretches and ankle mobility stretches. I can hang out in the bottom for a couple of reps too if I want. I don't expend too much energy, but I wanna make sure that I've lubed up the joints, got my hips open and my ankles open. I wanna make sure that I'm not doing an excessive amount of sets before I get to my max effort set, because I don't wanna completely tire myself out and I don't wanna waste a ton of time. I like to treat every rep of a set as though it's a one rep max. That way I can work on perfecting the movement pattern and getting better and better at what it is that I'm trying to do. In between each rep, I'm starting and finishing with a neutral spine. I'm squeezing the butt cheeks, getting the core nice and tight and bracing, turning on the lats by pulling down on the bar. One of the things I always like to do as well when I'm setting up my rack is to make sure my J hooks are set up at a height that I can essentially walk my bar right back into. One of the dangerous things I see people doing all the time is they'll get one side of the bar on, and while they're trying to get the other side of the bar on, the first side of the bar falls off, and then they end up dropping the bar. If you set up your J hooks so you can walk back into the rack, you can be confident you're not gonna drop anything, hurt yourself or someone else. Oh, 12. So this is the main set here for me. I'm gonna do my best to go balls to the wall here to get all 12 reps. Okay, this shouldn't be easy. You shouldn't be able to get 13 or 14 reps with this. This is a max effort set. So the concept of ramping up, it's usually used during our max effort lifts. And the idea is that we want to potentiate the nervous system. All that means is to make the nervous system more potent so that we can use more of the muscle we have by increasing the magnitude of the response from the brain to the muscle. Max effort, baby. Exercise two is gonna be the same as exercise one, only what we're doing is we're cutting down our top weight to 80% of what we managed to get on that first round, okay? So if, for example, I did 200 pounds for my max weight on my safety bar squat, I'm gonna cut down to 160 pounds for the next few sets of this exercise, okay? The idea here with this one is we're gonna be getting lots of rep work in here so we can build up strength in that exercise after doing our max. Again, the tempo here on this one is gonna be a 2-0-1-0. So the only difference here is we're not worried about exploding the weight up, we're just gonna do the contractile phase in a nice controlled motion. Keep in mind, we still want our 90 second rests in between sets here. Oh, 12. Whew. All right, 90 second rest, rinse and repeat. We wanna make sure we get a nice controlled descent with that 2 second eccentric. With this one, we're just driving up in a controlled manner. That first variation, we were trying to explode through. This one, we just wanna get the weight up. It's gonna hurt tomorrow. I can tell already. If you wanna use a belt, by all means, go ahead. Belts are a really good way to keep your back safe. Sometimes they help add a little bit extra weight to your lift because you can brace into the belt.
Okay, let's go.
You guys are trying to figure out how to breathe properly for these. One of the best analogies I've heard is to imagine when you squat down, you're squatting down in water that's about this deep. You're gonna take a big deep breath and hold. And you're not gonna exhale until you get out of the water, okay? So make sure you hold your breath until you get out of the hardest part of the movement. Never exhale at the bottom of a squat. Our next exercise is the leg press, okay guys? Nothing terribly magical here. We're gonna do 3 sets, 10 to 12 reps, 2-0-1-0 is gonna be our tempo. Now, if you wanna do a little bit more of a quad dominant variation of this, you're gonna keep your feet a little bit lower on your leg press plate. If you wanna hit a little bit more of the posterior chain, you can put your feet up a little bit higher on the plate. You pick, deciding on what your weak point is. As a rule, it comes down to shin angle. Now, totally up to you guys if you want to get up and walk around, flush out some of the lactic acid from your legs in between sets here. Just remember, we want to keep our rest to 90 seconds. I kind of like to just sit here. This is my chance to be lazy in a workout and just relax a little bit. I've switched now to AminoFast. Got my PPK done, but I love to use AminoFast during my workouts to help keep me hydrated, give me that extra boost, extra energy as I'm going, help me to recover a little bit more quickly. All right, round number two. You really want to make sure that you're holding yourself into the seat. If you're not keeping yourself pinned down, when you push against the weight, instead of your power going into the plate, you push yourself out of the seat. Try really holding yourself into that seat hard. All right, last time. Careful getting up too fast from that one. Want to make sure there's no sharp edges around in case you fall over and pass out. Want my knees to be in line with my ankles. If you're doing a leg press like that, really tough on the knees, wears down the knees really quick. My low back starts to round. It's equivalent to rounding your lower back at the bottom of the squat, which can potentially lead to injury. So avoid that, keep that in mind. Our next exercise is a Bulgarian split squat. Now, I've sort of put these in here. I know everyone hates these, but these are one of the best leg building exercises you can do. So deal with it. All right, we got 3 sets of 10 to 12 reps. And again, our tempo here is gonna be a 2 second negative, 0 pause, 1 second concentric with that one. One thing I've found is that I can reach back a lot easier if I hinge forward first. So I'm gonna come down a little bit like an RDL. I get a little bit more terminal hip extension there and I can hit my bench a little bit easier. Remember, slow deep breaths. If you need air, don't be like me, don't talk. Another thing I find helpful when I'm doing my reps, I try to keep my eyes focused on one spot. A lot of times when I find people are having a hard time balancing, their eyes are everywhere. They're looking at everything that's going on in the gym. You can't stay balanced with your eyes going in 100 different directions. All right, time for the last set. Oh, the worst part about this is this wasn't even invented by the Bulgarians, so you can't blame them. I think whoever invented this just didn't want to take the blame, so they just named it after another country altogether. I probably would have done the same. Not necessary to go to failure on every single set, but if you like pain, feel free to go to failure on the last set of each exercise. I have found, both for myself and for my clients, if the foot position is off, balance is always going to be off. So I always start making sure my front foot is pointing straight ahead. And at the tail end of the workout, we've got a gnarly superset for you here, where we've got lying hamstring curls superset with dumbbell Romanian deadlifts, okay? Both exercises, we got 4 sets of 10 to 12 reps. Again, doing our 2-second negative, 0 pause with a 1-second concentric action on that. That will finish you off quite nicely, I'm sure. You don't have to use a lying hamstring curl. There's standing variations, there's seated variations. This is just one of my personal favorites, so I'm gonna use this one today. Let's get to it. So essentially, we're hitting the same muscle group with both exercises. We could also call this a pre-exhaust. We're tiring the hamstring out individually before we use it here in a compound movement. Stance-wise, I tend to like my feet about hip width. And I treat this very much like a deadlift, just with very limited knee bend. I'm only gonna bend my knees just slightly, so I can take the pressure off of them, and my range of motion is going to be dictated by my hamstring mobility. How far can I get down while keeping a straight lower back? I do not want my lower back to round in this exercise. So if you hurt the shoulder, that sucks. You hurt the elbow, that sucks. You hurt the back, you're out of the game for a while. Round two. Key here is that I want to make sure I don't absolutely obliterate myself. I got 2 sets left. I'm gonna bang out set number 3 here. Baby, that was killer. Take a couple minutes, catch your breath. If you want to get in some work capacity stuff, you might throw in some sled pulls, some carries, maybe some high intensity intervals on an assault bike or a row machine, or even just some gentle steady state cardio for 10 to 20 minutes at the end to get in a little bit of work capacity, a little bit of that cardiovascular work, and to help you recover more quickly from your workouts. All right, guys, that's the end of today's workout. If you like this workout, make sure you hit like and subscribe, because we got 7 more of these videos coming out in the near future, and they're all gonna be awesome. If you had a hard time getting through the ramp up sets, if you had a hard time figuring out which weights you're doing, that kind of stuff, don't worry about it. We figure this stuff out as we go. Make sure you click on that PDF download below too, because that'll give you all the extra information you need to get all these workouts dialed in. All right, don't forget to hit like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next video. Cheers.